JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for December the 10th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, head of research here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's mini market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded higher against all but two of the other major currencies on Thursday during the Asian session Friday. It underperformed only versus the yen and the pound, while it gained the most against the Aussie, the Kiwi and the Loonie. Now, the strengthening of the Japanese yen and the US dollar, combined with the weakening of the risk linked to Aussie, Kiwi and Loonie, suggests that markets may have turned to risk off yesterday and today in Asia. Indeed, turning our gaze to the equity world, we see that all but one of the EU indices finished their session in the red, with the only exception being Italy's FTSE MIB. The negative appetite rolled over into the US and Asian sessions as well. Although the Dow Jones closed virtually unchanged, the S&P 500 fell 0.72% and Nasdaq 1.71%. In Asia, all the indices under our radar were down. After recording their strongest two-day rally in more than a year, European shares pulled back perhaps due to concerns over stricted COVID-related measures across the block. Yes, we have studies that the symptoms of the Omicron variant are not as severe as initially thought, and this was already cheered by the market. But the fact that it is more transmissible than prior strains keeps the risk of more measures high in our view. What's more, a less dangerous variant doesn't mean that the other ones have disappeared. Now, what may have also prompted market participants to reduce their risk exposure during the US and Asian sessions may be the fact that today we get the US CPIs for November. Therefore, it remains to be seen whether market participants are still willing to add risk in the aftermath of the CPIs. This could mean that positive news with regards to Omicron is not fully priced in yet. On the other hand, a prolonged slide could mean that the investors are more worried over another potential economic slowdown. That's why we prefer to take things step by step, and now try to examine the possible reaction of the markets to the outcome of the US CPIs. Now, the headline CPI is forecast to have accelerated further to 6.8% year over year from 6.2%, while the core rate is expected to have increased to 4.9% year over year from 4.6%. Last week, Fed Chair Jerome Powell appeared hawkish before the US Congress, surprising those expecting him to adopt a more cautious stance due to the new coronavirus variant and the restrictive measures adopted around the globe. In contrast, the Fed chief said that the transitory wording with regards to inflation may have to be dropped out of the Fed's monetary policy statement, and that quantitative easing tapering should end sooner than previously estimated. Despite non-farm payrolls missing expectations on Friday, the unemployment rate declined even more to 4.2% from 4.6%, and combined with further acceleration in the CPIs, it could add more credence to Powell's view. Faster tapering could also mean faster rate hikes, and thereby a stronger dollar. Now, as for equities, with market participants turning somewhat skeptical again with regards to the future performance of the global economy, they may decide to sell stocks for a bit more on speculation that higher borrowing costs sooner could hurt companies' profitability. However, because they may have digested the idea to some extent, we don't expect a large and extended fall. Now, as for the rest of today's events, during the European morning, we already got the UK monthly GDP for October alongside the industrial and manufacturing production rates for the same month, all of which disappointed. Although the pound did not react much at the time of the release, this, combined with concerns that the new measures imposed by Prime Minister Boris Johnson could hamper the economy more, may convince more participants to take off the table bets with regards to a December hike by the Bank of England. Now, later in the day, besides the US CPIs for November, the only other release worth mentioning is the preliminary University of Michigan Consumer Sentiment Index for December, which is expected to have slid to 67.1 from 67.4. We also have four ECB speakers on today's agenda, and those are ECB President Christine Lagarde, ECB Executive Board Member Fabio Panetta, Executive Board Member Frank Elterson, and Supervisory Board Member Elizabeth McCall. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 8 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, a greater weekend, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again next week.
JFT, just fair and direct.